my ribs touch. I remember sleeping with my ribs touch. Now I get it to go.
Grind game over, time's up. Play my cards, dumb, my hand ain't really no time for luck. Either you got it, you don't. Lie to yourself if you won't. I put my team on my back. Did what I could, what I had. Now I'll be all in my bag. Copy and paste with the swag. Bet you can't do it like me. All my winnings on repeat. Take your L like a boss. Standing toes on your feet. I can never take a loss. I ain't set up for defeat. Four Giottos on the truck. I had a dream and it's stuck. Living my life cause we up. Looking back like where the love. That's why I be hella low key. But contrary to belief, loyalty runs deep. I keep my ear to the streets. Struggle turn me to a beast. I'm off the chain, I'm off the leash. But baby girl, I play for keeps. Told my brother lately, I've been scheming. Against all odds like Willie Beeman. I've been grinding lately, this my season. Lord knows I'm trying to find my reason. Lay it out on the line, ain't no looking back. Giving my all with no strings attached. Can't roll the bottom, roll through the cracks. Spotlight on you, boy, how you gon' act?
Hey, I remember sleeping with my ribs touched. I remember sleeping with my ribs touched. Now, I get it to go.
Thank you. Afternoon in the heart of Texas. No weather to speak of. Sun out, roof open. Yes, yes, and yes. A great day for football at AT&T Stadium in Arlington. Obviously, they do everything big here in Dallas, and the introduction to the Cowboys, no exception. They're set for football and Big D as their guys will do battle with the New York Giants. Just starting training camp, but here we are in October, and off we go on EA Sports. This is Tony Pollard. And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line.
At their own 25-yard line.
Carry for Ezekiel Elliott, and they're able to get this one across the 35. Give him 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give him a first down.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down, otherwise it's going to be a long afternoon.
They keep on the ground with Elliott. That one good for 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And all of a sudden here, it's third down. The first carry now for Tony Pollard. And some room to work. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. Touchdown, Cowboys. Tony Pollard. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Cowboys have taken the early lead. Now Greg Zuerlein on for the extra point. And this is up and good to make it 7-0 Cowboys.
Breaks the score, Cowboys 7, Giants nothing.
Thank you. is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22.
Valentine on the return. The Giants take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
And they'll come out with a three tight end look on the first play of the drive. On the ground, this is Saquon Barkley. And he's got some space here. And now look at him go. Past the 20. And he will take it on in for a Giant touchdown. Saquon Barkley, 78 yards. And the Giants are an extra point away from tying up this football game. Well, go ahead and strap in, partner. Less than 2 minutes in, had the score on the one side. A quick answer, though, to get the equalizer.
Sometimes you get that sense of urgency that ratchets up, right? When you give up an early touchdown like that, you just know, you're like, okay, how do we go back and equalize things? Can we get it done fast? And they absolutely did. Essentially, we're back to even, aren't we?
And they will wrangle him down a couple yards shy of the 30.
Cowboys take over first and 10. At their own 28-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves them with a 2nd and 3.
2nd and 3 at the 34-yard line.
It'll be a handoff to Pollard. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. That one, a first down pickup of 8. His first carry of their second drive, pretty solid. And, of course, remember back to their first drive, really strong throughout that one.
Not only is he getting good blocking up front, but how about his vision to find the holes? And he's seeing things before they even open and hurtling through them.
Down carry by Elliott, and not much there at all. Maybe a yard up to the 43.
He's brought down by Jabril.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. A really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
On 2nd and 9, Prescott got an open man, the tight end Jarwin. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Good work after the catch. Gets him 15 and a first down.
I know this may be jumping the gun a little bit, but 7-7, they're flinging it around like crazy. Look at the drive that's going on here. Partner, we may have to start thinking about one of these defenses just holding someone to a field goal and maybe trying to get advantage that way.
So the drive takes them into Giants territory now, 1st and 10 at the 43. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, 2nd and 2.
The ball carrier.
You often say that sort of opens the playbook now, 2nd and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
On 2nd down, Elliott. And this time not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, 1st down.
Well, they came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football. I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on 1st and 10. This is Elliott. He winds up getting only a couple there, down to the 29.
Again, the ball carrier.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
He's got the connection to Cooper. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Giants' 18.
Well, remember, they tried to give him the ball and let him run on the last play, but I think the light bulb went off in their play caller's mind, and this time they get it to him the more conventional way, and it's much more successful as well.
Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. A nice little screen. They get six on first down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still ended up with a solid gain.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion. So here's second and four. Now back to the ground with Elliott. And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Ezekiel Elliott, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Cowboys have taken the lead. It's up and good, and it's 14-7 now here in the first quarter.
Cowboys 14, Giants 7.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line.
Corey Valentine on the return. The Giants take over first and 10 at their own 27-yard line.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And they hit the home run last drive. One play on the ground all the way to the house. Now the defense, maybe they're expecting a run here.
Gardner, I love your description, because when we talk about hitting the home run, we're usually thinking about a passing play, aren't we? Something in the air, deep ball. But how about them just taking it big-time jaunt? Now if you're coming back out, now they've established this run game, the play-action pass could very well be open.
Now a quick throw as that's complete on the hitch route. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. 7 yards there and a first down.
A gain of 7. First down, Giants.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Jones with a handoff to Barkley. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. First down, Giants on a pickup of 14.
47-yard line. A gain of 14. And the Giants' first down. That's the
through one quarter, 14-7, our score.
Giants 7.
So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10 at the 47. Throwing, Jones. He'll get this out to Barkley, complete. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays.
First down, New York.
Now Lewis here on first down. He'll be dropped at the 25 after a gain of 6.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
From the 25 on second down, Jones. That's complete. He's got Barkley out of the backfield. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
First down, New York.
This drive, it's been a good mix. 3 passing plays, 3 runs, hitting on all 3 of those passes, and the last one putting him in the red zone.
So wouldn't you think play action right here? Because you've got the ability and had the ability to run it and throw it. Go play action and take your shot at the end zone.
He's brought down
a gain of 3, second down.
A 3-yard
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
On second down, here's Barkley. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Officially no gain on the play, and they're left with a third and eight. This defense against the run, by the way, they're not top five, but they are top ten.
So what's your philosophy here? Do you try and run the ball against a team that's pretty good against the run? What if you're a pretty good running team? If so, you might want to go ahead and run it anyway, because that's your strength.
Gets this out to Saquon Barkley. And the tackle made at the 13. He is well short of the first. That's going to bring up fourth down. Only a gain of two there.
That's a good job there by the corner. We do talk about this a lot, that a lot of corners see their job as simply covering receivers. Tackling isn't everyone's thing. But in this case, he came up quickly and made a nice short tackle.
So the drive stalls out inside the 15-yard line, but they do get three.
And I've talked with enough players nowadays, and when they have these types of kicks, that no one says to their guy, hey, that's just like making an extra point, piece of cake. Because the extra point is not a piece of cake anymore. But kicking a field goal from that distance, just give him confidence and let him knock it through.
The Cowboys take over first and 10 at their own 19-yard line.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and two.
Brings up second and two at the 27-yard line.
They stay on the ground, but this time it's Elliott. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. That's a good chunk of yardage. It's going to be canceled out.
And we always talk about hidden yardage in a game. That's going to count as that, because now it doesn't go on the books, but now they have to make that up again, don't they?
Second down, Prescott. He's got a man complete. It's Amari Cooper. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. 15 yards on the play, first down.
First and 10.
It's funny when I go back to our pregame meeting with Amari Cooper and we mentioned, what if they play man coverage against you? He almost seemed offended by it, didn't he?
I'll beat it. That's basically what he said, right?
I mean, the best receivers we've ever talked to and covered, when you talk about covering them with one guy, they think that's a personal affront. If they feel like they can't just beat one defender, then they're not very good.
Another strong gain on the last two plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards.
First and 10 at the 46-yard line.
So the drive takes them into Giants territory now. First and 10 at the 46. Prescott from the gun. This to Jarwin. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. Second and five after the 5-yard completion on first down. Now a give here to Pollard. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down.
I'm not sure how much more evidence they need, partner, than to understand that if they don't start to slow him down, it's going to be a long afternoon here at the stadium, because he is just shredding them at this point. And let's face it, coming into the game, they knew he would be the focal point of their attack. This is going to take an 11-man unit on the defensive side to start making plays.
And down inside the 15 he goes. 10 more there and another first down.
That's another Cowboys first down. First and 10 at the 14-yard line.
2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck with me in this booth,
yes,
and he's
I
miles
am.
Away and smiling.
And happy.
Got out of the pocket, didn't look like he had anybody open, Charles, so just gets rid of it.
And a good play by him. If no one's open and you don't have a running lane that you want to take, make the right choice, get rid of it, live to fight another down.
An incomplete pass on first down, that leads to a second and 10.
Stay.
10th carry now for Elliott. And this carry terminated at the 8-yard line. Good stick skill showing the power, but just not much room to operate. They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4.
Makes it 3rd and 4.
This will be the 8th play of the drive here. 3rd and 4. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. This will be caught at about the 5. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. The Giants going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. Simple math here. The first half, they've had 3 drives offensively, and they have scored every time, and they've got the lead.
Well, whenever we talk about adjustments, we usually talk about an offense making adjustments, right? This is all about the defense. They've got to figure out some way, somehow, to slow them down. Do they blitz a little bit more? Do they play more zone coverage? Right now, they don't know where to go because they're hitting them in every direction.
And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29.
On the return, the Giants take over 1st and 10 at their own 29-yard line.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. There was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You could never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
Nine brings up 2nd and 1 yard.
And they'll employ the jumbo set now on 2nd and 1. Here's a give to Barkley. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play, and now they're faced with a 3rd and 1.
Taken down right at the line.
Those are the plays this defense needs with the deficit they're facing.
It certainly is, and they've got to continue to swarm the football and hope that someone, while they're holding up the ball carrier, can get in there and rake it and lock it free. They need to get some takeaways as well.
From the gun on 3rd down, Jones. And that is incomplete.
So many times when we talk about coverage, we're just talking about a defender running with a receiver, but a big part of it is understanding where the football is, finding it. In this case, when it arrived, it wasn't a surprise, and he was able to bat it away.
And he couldn't get it to check up. That kicks all the way into the end zone for a touchback.
Their own 20-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. You've got less than 30 seconds left here in the half. You're well on your own side of the field. What are we doing here, Coach Davis?
Well, I'm trying something on 1st down. And it's something that's safe. It's something that's been done many times before. A lot of people say it's not even worth trying, but I'm running a draw. I'm running a screen. I'm seeing if something pops. And if it does, that can alter my strategy and potentially get me some points. And if it doesn't work, well, then you just run the clock out and go to the locker room.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on 1st and 10. Out of the gun, here's Prescott. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. The Cowboys going to use their 2nd timeout now. As the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half. The loss of three on that first down pass play. Now second and 13. Prescott. He'll fire deep downfield and got his man complete. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. Now a signal and a timeout call as it comes with 9 seconds to go in this first half of play.
At the 35-yard line.
So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. From the left hash, this will be a 52-yard attempt. And this won't get there. Won't be online either. It's no good. Off to the right. And this score will stay right where it is.
NFL kickers nowadays, they make things look so easy because normally from this range, about 2 out of 3. And this is not an easy kick.
Yeah, 20 years ago, you get where he was in that 50 range, maybe a little over. And it's a big kick. But now we just, if they leave it short, you're like, whoa, what happened? And that's what we have here.
Yeah, you're right. 20 years ago, we were saying run some more plays and get closer. Now we think they're definitely within range. And you're exactly right. When it comes up short, there has to be something that went wrong because they have plenty of leg.
He's going to rifle one deep left side. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. So we have reached halftime here in an 11-point contest. As we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach. The Giants set to get the football, and they trail here as we get back underway. In the second half, on the return, Corey Ballantyne. The lane opens here. He's past the 30.
Corey Ballantyne on the return. The Giants take over first and 10 at their own 31-yard line.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned. Because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. A solid way to start the drive. 13 yards picking up the first. First down carry for Barkley. Pushing forward for three up to the 48.
26, Saquon Barkley.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
From just shy of midfield, Jones, and this is incomplete.
You get the sense that they're saying we're not playing up to what we're capable of and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
Here's Jones on third down. And that will be incomplete.
We're into the second half now. This is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off. Dixon, the punter, is on as he sends it away. Oh, he takes it in. Doesn't let it bounce. He takes it at the 2. A nice run back there off the good punt. It's a 16-yard return. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
Hey, how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion.
Push it back. Push it back. Shit.
They go go to Elliott again. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
They'll go with Pollard here on first down. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
Brings up second and five.
Gonna run again here with Pollard. And that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. A loss on that play, and now third down gets tougher. Third and six. And now the Giants, they get the officials' attention and take another timeout. And that's going to leave them with just one timeout remaining still in the third quarter. We'll see if that comes back to haunt them. We'll be back. They play fake to Elliott. Now Prescott. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Marcus Golden, too much to handle that time, gets the sack. Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result? Quarterback gets hit.
And just a single punt for him in the loss last week as he sends this one away. Tate on the return. He'll call this a 41-yard punt, 7 on the return. And it'll be Giant football first and 10. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut him, all right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But hey, listen, there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
And he is brought down, but not before reaching the 30. 22 yards on the catch and run, a first down.
22 yards.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open. Just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last two plays. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. This is Lewis on the handoff. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down.
Pardon, if you want more carries, I think we saw how you get him. Showed that he's got the fresh legs, and he picked up the first down on that run. Don't just ask for him. Show him that you're supposed to get the football.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. They get this out left, and he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
A gain of 3.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there, swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
And Barkley will try to punch it in. And this is not going to do it as he stopped at the 2-yard line. It'll go as no gain on the play, and now they're looking at a third and goal. Big play coming here. It's third and goal. Here's Barkley. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. He needed 3, he got 2. Now that'll set up an interesting situation here on 4th and a yard.
At the 1-yard line.
So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. From the right hash at a bit of a tight angle. And the 11-year veteran bangs it through. And that'll make this an 8-point game. They took it all the way to the one, but in the end, opt for three.
Just doesn't sound right, does it? If you got all the way down to the 1-yard line, isn't that supposed to be a play in the end zone that culminates in a touchdown for your team?
And per usual, it felt like the guys on the sideline wanted to go ahead and go for it.
Of course they did, but of course head coach, it defers back to him, and he made the decision, let's get three out of this, make sure we get some points.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Options galore here, second and a few inches. Again, it's Elliott. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. It'll be a loss of one, and that'll bring up a third and one.
Third down.
Prescott down. And he'll have his man. That's Cooper. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Instead of a third and one run, they go pass and they get 12 yards out of it. And that's going to do it. Clock hits zeros. They're not going to get another playoff. Time has run out on this third quarter. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. First down, it's Elliott, and he'll work it across midfield instantly. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
And we're seeing the effect that runs like that are starting to have on this game. They're a little bit slower, that front seven reacting to the football, almost like body blows in boxing, slowing them down, and they're really starting to take over in this game.
So the drive takes them into Giants territory now, first and 10 at the 43. Prescott gets this to the tight end, Jarwin. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards, and that'll make it second and a foot or so.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down, stomped down. How about that? Back-to-back completions. They are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football. On second down, it's Pollard. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. That'll set them back with a loss of three on the play. And they're going to have a third down. Here's Pollard again. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Tony Pollard with his second touchdown of the game and fifth on the year. And the Cowboys will add on to their lead. Zerline now for the PAT. And the lead is up to 15 now.
Good. Makes the score Cowboys 28. Giants 13.
The kickoff unit is out on the field and they will send this one away. And this will make it into the end zone. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards.
Take over first and 10. At their own 21-yard line.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
We're looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder, puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get six and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score. From all the way up at the 38 now after a good start to the drive. Now Jones. It's hauled in by Shepard. 3 yards the gain there, second down. You got the big lead defensively, willing to give them that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle them after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
That first down completion only netted him 3. Second and 7. Now this pass into the hands of Saquon Barkley. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. That one a gain of 20 and a first down.
Good yardage on the completion there. And when they look at the scoreboard, they do understand a field goal is not going to do them any good. My guess, they're going to press the ball downfield as far as possible, try and throw it into the end zone and get a score because they know they've got to get that done and get the ball back as quickly as possible.
He hits his target. It's the tight end, Toy Lolo. A good rally to the football keeps him to only a yard, and it's second down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. You're tackling them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
To throw again on second down, Jones. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 12. And he'll return it to the 24-yard line. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape. He's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
Following the interception, here's Prescott, able to hit his target, Lamb. And they work this well upfield across the 45. 22 yards on the catch and run, a first down. What a difference a week makes. 5 interceptions in their last game. Here we are, fourth quarter. He's played mistake-free football.
And I'm sure that we can look back on the past week and say, okay, he spent time in the film room and they worked on his mechanics. Sometimes it's just your team believing in you, your coaching staff believing in you, and you relax and play to your potential. He's doing that in this game.
And he's out of bounds as he gets this down to the 45. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
A game there of 30 big ones.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. CeeDee Lamb. His second touchdown on the season. And the Cowboys, they push out in front further. So the touchdown there, and that play, the tap pass, so simple, Charles, on the face of it, but what makes it so difficult for defenses to stop?
I think it's the precision and the quickness in which the play occurs because the snap gets to the quarterback. He's essentially playing volleyball with it, just immediately just shoveling it forward. And when that receiver is at a full head of steam, if you don't take the edge away, he's got a chance to get to the corner and get upfield. But if you take the edge away, that's your chance to disrupt that play.
And no disruption there, that's for sure, as it winds up 6 points. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. Now, this game went off the rails early for them and never really got back on track. And these fans, they were expecting to be on the other side of the scoreboard, but that is not the case as we play on here this fourth quarter.
And nearly picked off there, almost intercepted. Instead, second down. To Barkley, and he's upended after a gain of four up to the 25-yard line.
The tackle. That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get him into a manageable third down, because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Giants football here as we welcome you back. They face a third down now as they try to find a late score. And Ingram hauls it in. And he gets it to the 32, good enough for a first down.
A gain of seven.
First down Giants, Jones to Ingram. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Operating from the gun, Jones. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. Put it into this return, but not before he's all the way down to the 37.
Jones pass.
Partner, we always talk about possessions being at a premium in these games, and now in this situation, throwing an interception here when you have to claw your way back in, that one's going to hurt, and in a big way.
To Elliott. Here's Prescott looking deep in the direction of, and this is caught, and they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals. They were still throwing with a comfortable lead here late, and now that lead even more comfortable.
And your first thought is it bad blood that went into this one ahead of time, that maybe they're seeking some revenge or they just don't like them? But the other thing that always hits me is, are they worried about playoff positioning? Right? Are they worried about, do you need enough points in case there's a tiebreaker that comes into play later?
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23.
The Giants take over first and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. This one certainly has not gone according to script. You would have thought on paper that this offense would have its way here, but they certainly have not, and they trail big. After this, it figures to be a quiet trip home. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
After the penalty, they go with Barkley. And he'll use his blockers to get this up over the 20 to the 21.
Tackle made at the 21.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. I can just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there. I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently. And
instead, he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30.
He's tackled at the.
They've got to give kudos to your offensive line and the guy carrying the ball because they were in a second and long situation. It seemed pretty dire, but they brought it back to third and manageable with that run.
On third down, Barkley. He'll have a first down past the 40. It's a foot race. 20, 10, and all the way in. Touchdown, New York.
Touchdown.
Saquon Barkley. His second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Giants are able to draw a bit closer. So what was already a game to remember becomes even more so as that touchdown run, a lengthy one, takes him over 200 yards now for the game.
And I love the fact that to get over 200, it took a pretty good sprint, didn't it? I mean, a lot of times you get 1 or 2 yards and they go, oh, he's over 200 yards. But that really put an exclamation point on the game he's having. Fantastic. A lot of fun to watch.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And this game just illustrates how important home field really is. On paper, didn't look like much of a matchup. But now, oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Amari Cooper with his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Cowboys will extend their lead. And that'll push the lead up to 29 now.
Makes the score Cowboys 49, Giants 20.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
First and 10. At their own 24-yard line.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. Remember, they have won 3 straight, but getting to 4 straight does not appear to be in the cards as they are in a big fourth quarter hole. And a missed tackle there as he pushes forward for a gain of 4.
Today's final score.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for the Cowboys, they move back over 500 at 3-2 now on the year. And they'll get to stay put for a few days as they'll host the Arizona Cardinals next week. Meanwhile, for the Giants, the loss will move them back to 3-2 on the year. And they will be back home next week for a date with Washington. I'm Brandon Gaudin. Certainly have to thank Charles Davis, my broadcast partner, and our entire crew. We'll catch you next time right here. It's the NFL on EA Sports.
style, don't ya? Nice like this, I wish I was with ya. On my turf, roll out the Henry Rux. She like when I hit the receiver. Friend hop in, this is a four-seater. Made a yank straight out the wood, I'm Derek Jeter. Major Liga, no fatiga. We don't get no henna, we don't get no macarinas. If we gon' throw your back out, tryna work, you'll need a breather.
I need a break.
Won't you get down with me, down with me, down with me? Oh, you down with me, down with me, down with me? Won't you get down with me, down with me, down with me? Oh, you down with me, down with me? Hold on. Won't you get down with me, down with me, down with me? Oh, you down with me, down with me, down with me? Oh, down with me, down with me, down with me? Oh, you down.
Tell me who you talking to.
Roll up that Sinatra, fly la mama to the moon. She asked me what's my life path. Told her 55 south to the cab. So many couches I cracked. Shout out Zozo, Tree Tree, and Shout Classic.
I know you really wanna be my only one, but I need somebody to hold on to the sucker.
take another L. Designer on me, this that new Chanel. Did that splash, did that drill. Hey, hey, champion, huh? Yeah, we here. Yeah, yeah, this the winning team. Six rings with a pinky ring. Everybody used to pick at me, now I'm the one that they picking. Snakes out, they hissing, but I can't hear it when the crowd screams. Still balling like an offspring. This for all the ones that doubted me. Gotta lose once to be a true winner.